According to the chairman of the Folk Research Center, Hilary LaForce, the quarto is used mainly in the introduction of folk music. Mr. LaForce says the quarto is basically dying out and being replaced by the banjo. But according to him, a band of quarto enthusiasts who are all aging now embarked on a workshop in collaboration with the Venezuelan embassy where the youth are now being tutored and hopefully will keep the tradition of quarto playing alive.
We hope that the government can support this kind of initiative. As you know, music is part of our culture. And as you know, with the new Ministry of Creative Industries, there's need to begin to nurture that kind of activity. So that's, as you know, it's a big business. Creative industries is a big business, and we want to ensure that solutions can begin to consider getting involved in culture, in music, in dance, so that this in itself can bring some well-needed revenue for our people.
One participant says it was easy for him and his colleagues who all play the guitar.
I find I picked up quite fine because I also play the guitar. And playing the guitar, it kind of makes it relatively easier for me. But for me, I find I've picked up great. My fellow colleagues as well, I find they've picked up excellently. I think a quarto is an instrument each and every one of us could play. I would actually recommend it to the government to actually implement more of those workshops for us, because actually it's my first time actually ever playing a quarto. I didn't even know what it looked like before 3 days ago. So,
the quarto is said to be quite expensive in the region of $400. Nonetheless, students are eager to have one. Awards were presented to many students who completed the workshop on Friday. For the DBS News World, Alex Bousquet reporting.